warmest of welcomes to you. We await the conclusion of the pre-game formalities. The teams then, Roma against CSKA Moscow. I'm Peter Drury, and it's my chance to say that it is an absolute delight to have Jim Beglin beside me. Hi, everyone, and thanks, Peter. It's great to be on board. The familiar strains of the anthem serving to raise the levels of expectation even higher. Roma, it is our understanding that they've gone with a 4-5-1.
Well, it's a formation, Peter, that lends itself to good possession and control in midfield because you've got the numbers there, a higher concentration. Backing that up with enough attacking dynamism is down to managers who want to get at teams. It can be used in cautious terms too. But certainly, if you want to advance a little quicker and you have that attitude, then you can be very positive about this too.
And that gets things running. Who do you think this turns on, Jim?
I'm going to go for the experienced Igor Akinfeev. He's always been an agile stopper, but having been on the scene from such a young age, he's a much calmer decision-maker these days.
I'm thinking the same. He will be a central feature, no doubt. That'll be a throw.
Pellegrini eyeing that space.
And it's hoisted clear. Fernandez.
Vlasic
plays it out to the wing and helps available out wide. It's got paid to a promising move.
De Rossi, Checo, and Zonzi.
Out to the left it goes.
Checo
floats one over. The ball needed to be better there, it's a wasted chance.
Just to point out, Peter, that the fullbacks are quite high.
And what do they try to achieve?
Well, it's obviously a move to push the opposition wide men back and give them more to think about.
Neither of the teams has yet taken the initiative. Goya goes up and over, gets into some space, and he just whacks it away. Has a quick glance. Jagoev, over to the left. Nicely controlled. Goya, the ball through. Last-ditch defending, but that'll do. Manolas boots it to safety, dinks one in, and he just whacks it away.
Midway through the first half, and there's an impotence about this game that's causing me concern, and probably most of the stadium too. Let's just hope that by the end, it'll have been forgotten.
Ferguson.
Aimed low and direct.
Fernandez. Jagoev. Olsen deals with it effortlessly.
Nice touch.
And it's Jagoev.
Forward it goes.
And it's hoisted clear.
That'll be a throw-in.
Looks to clip it forward. And he just whacks it away.
Ditch defending, but that'll do.
Great strength, too strong for his opponent.
And he's certainly caught him there, it's a free kick. Under. Florenzi.
Lovely bit of skill.
Tries a through ball.
Fernandez, Jagoev,
Magnussen,
Vlasic.
For a throw.
It's Fernandez.
Vlasic. Fernandez with the cross.
And Lolas boots it to safety.
Got through.
A reprieve, albeit perhaps momentary.
And there's the end of the first half.
So the other team has broken through. Certainly not going to want to try.
Interesting game up to now. Still goals.
Do it back on the first 45 minutes.
Well, this has proved a very frustrating day so far, especially for the strikers. Nothing has been created for them. I think the service has been extremely poor.
So they head in no further forward. The score here, still 0-0. Here we go again then.
Roma pretty fortunate not to be trailing at half-time. They've been lacklustre and second best for me. If ever a situation demanded a telling off from the boss, it's this one. He has to spark a reaction.
Manolas. Florenzi.
Deftly done.
And it's hoisted clear.
De Rossi. El-Sharawi, that intervention was very necessary.
Vlasic.
Magnussen. Fernandez. Jagoev. Fernandez.
Vlasic.
Yeah, that's top defending and preventing him turning, which can open up many possibilities.
Under.
Under. Still nothing to reflect upon in terms of goals here. It is 1-0. Played out to the right.
De Rossi.
Kolarov.
Al-Sharawi.
Kolarov. Now the pass.
Dzeko,
he's onside. Keeper's got good distance on that. Tries to get it forward quickly.
He acknowledges that he should have come up with something better there.
Oh, that just required a bit more oomph to reach its target.
Chances to talk of, Jim. Defences, it seems, on top here.
Well, I think it's a fair reflection on what we've seen so far. Neither side has produced that many efforts at goal simply because respective defences have been strong.
And that's been levered clear. Out to the left it goes. Now it's Jagoev. I think that's a corner. Yes, it is. Roma can make their change now with a break in play. Last-ditch defending, but that'll do. Who's ball? Who's going to get there? Throw-in. Final checks on the touchline. A change about to occur. And he just whacks it away. Jagoev. Plays it out to the flank.
Look at the defender bombing forward.
Is an awful miss.
Oh no, that was a chance. What a chance.
Vlasic.
Jagoev.
Magnussen plays it out wide.
Oh, sweet feet.
CSKA Moscow merit full marks for their attitude and application in trying to win this. It means an awful lot, obviously.
He's got out of play. There's going to be another change here.
Well, his stamina was called into question then, but there's absolutely nothing wrong with his heart and the efforts he put in. He was very willing, though, not quite able.
Aimed low and direct. And it's Jagoev. Looks like a good ball through. Got a throw in. Basio knocks it away, looks to slip it through.
CSKA Moscow showing a good level of intensity at this stage. They're calling on all their resources now.
Lorenzi passes it through. And that's a throw.
Looks to slip it through.
Look, this can still go either way. It might be flowing one way, but there's still time for some ebb.
Fernandez keeps everyone guessing.
And Zonzi.
So that's it. It is all over.
Well, it looked nil-nil from a fair way out.
Little craft or guile or penetration. Defence is largely untroubled. It's goals.